South Bass Island is located in southwestern Lake Erie and is surrounded by many other small islands. The island was first explored by Europeans in the 1600s. After American colonists broke away from Great Britain in the Revolutionary War, the island became part of the Connecticut Reserve. In 1795, many of the Erie Islands, including South Bass, were put up for sale. In 1807, Pierpont Edwards purchased South Bass, along with six other islands, for a sum of $26,087. 6 years later, during the War of 1812, this was a pivotal area.
The island's first use was exporting timber, limestone, and cordwood to the mainland. In 1854, José de Rivera Saint Hurgo purchased the land for $44,000. He began preparing the island for wine production. Soon, 60% of the island was covered with vineyards.
As a result of the wineries, tourism increased tremendously on South Bass Island.
Today, the island is home to approximately 400 to 500 year-round residents. Most of these people own businesses on the island. Due to the freezing winter, almost all of the island's activity occurs during the hot summer months. Tourism is the largest source of income. To reach South Bass, you can either take a ferry, small aircraft, or personal boat. South Bass and other Erie Islands are unique in that their primary source of transportation is the golf cart.
A large attraction on the island is Perry's Monument, which stands 352 feet tall. This makes it the third largest monument in the U.S., only behind the Washington Monument and the St. Louis Arch. Commodore Oliver Hazard Perry led a fleet of 9 U.S. ships into the Battle of Lake Erie, a crucial turning point in the War of 1812. His victory prevented the British from penetrating into the U.S. and possibly capturing the Northwest Territory. The monument was constructed both to honor his victory and as a symbol of peace between the U.S. and Canada.
Though only 3 miles in diameter, the island has 28 cave systems beneath it. Two of these are currently open to the public. Crystal Cave is the world's largest geode, measuring over 30 feet long. A geode is usually defined as a cavity in rock lined with crystals. All of the cave's crystals are orthorhombic, which is why every one of its 18 sides come together to form 104 degree angles.
Perry's Cave is the largest of the 28 caves on South Bass. It is made of limestone and was formed when the water caused the expansion of hydrate between two layers of rock. After the hydrate washed away, the space between the rocks remained, creating a cave.
Inside of the cave is a body of water of an unknown size. Many believe that it may even connect to Lake Erie because of the way its water fluctuation is similar to that of the lakes. It was originally used for drinking water, but now, due to people throwing coins in, it is too contaminated to drink.
The cave has interesting geological features, such as stalactites, which are columns hanging down from the ceiling of the cave due to calcium from dripping water. The stalactites grow at a rate of about 1 inch every 500 years. There are also stalagmites, which are columns coming up from the floor. These grow at a faster rate than the stalactites due to the fact that they are made up of more minerals.
We've had a great day here on South Bass Island. I'm not sure which of the sites I like best.
In addition to all of the sites that we showed you, we took a tour of the island on a tram, and we ate in one of the many fine restaurants in Put-in Bay. We also visited the winery and toured a museum.
South Bass Island is a fun and educational place to bring your family. Until next time, this is Tyler, Greg, and Zach saying so long.